roll one on some chill shit. I was deep asleep on my Kill Bill shit, but now I'm back for it all, trying to steal shit.
Hey guys, Vermin here, and today I'm going to give you guys my Twixtor settings as promised. It's just a mini special for 850 subscribers, so thank you guys for that. And I'm also going to give you a couple tips on how to use Twixtor and make it have as less warp as possible. And the first one to do is the obvious disable resample, but to also uncheck maintain aspect ratio, because what that does is it makes it to where Twixtor gets kind of compressed between what your project settings are, which mine are 1280 by 720. So if you compress it, then it doesn't really, it warps more. That's like the best and easiest way I can say it. And these are my project settings. If you want to copy them down, I choose to do 8-bit, because if I do 32-bit, then whenever I use any like third-party plugins like New Blue FX, for example, the preview box gets completely red and it always crashes on render, so I just prefer 8-bit, and it's really not that different at all, as you can tell. And so here are my settings right here. So you can go ahead and copy these down. And the way that you want to use Twixtor, especially for episodes, is you want to Twixtor the game-winning kill cam, because it's already slower. So it's not as fast, which means not as fast, less warp. You can see like how much slower it is compared to the actual end game time. You can still, you know, with these settings, you can still Twixtor end game time, but you would it's gonna look much better with the round winning kill. And just a general tip is when the scope is coming up and about to get off the screen, it's gonna start making this right side of the screen start to kind of have like this line warp. It's gonna try and blend them both together, and it's gonna look kind of weird. So you want to stay away from that. So about right there, that's probably as far as I'd like the Twixtor to go, and then begin the transition. It's just simple stuff like that. You never want to use it when they're spinning, otherwise it's gonna warp. You know, this is basically general stuff, but you only really want the Twixtor one still. And you know, the scope thing is just a little tip. I'll also give you guys my render settings, just in case, you know, if you want them, I guess. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna apply the Twixtor, and I'm gonna show you a way to transition from real time to slower speed, rather than just splitting the clip and then put the Twixtor on. It's a way to make a smoother transition. So right here is where we're gonna have the Twixtor slowly start. So we're gonna animate, and I'm just gonna make this box smaller so you can see. And then we're gonna click this. So it starts off right at the line. And we're gonna set this to 100%. So I'm just gonna change it to 101, so it makes a keyframe. And then I'm gonna change it again to 100. And then we're just gonna go forward a bit to, let's see, about this long of a transition would be good, and then we'll just drop that to 4%. And what's going to happen is, you see, if we go in between these lines, you can see the number changing from 100 to 4. So I'm going to drop this to draft quarter, just because, to make the RAM render faster, and then you'll see that it slowly transitions into that slow Twixtor. Instead of just snapping thing. And you might see warp already. So if we go here, I'm actually gonna RAM render it with preview auto, just so it's easier for you guys to see. If you kinda look on the edges of the scope, see how it's kinda warping right there? You don't have to worry about stuff like that. Cause see how there's a gray shade on the round ending kill? That makes all the colors darker. You add a color correction on there, it's gonna blend in to be darker, and all you're gonna be seeing is the color correction. You're not gonna see the warp of the raw clip. What they're gonna see is towards the brighter colors, which is right here. I'm just gonna put this on loop, which is right here on the edge of the barrel and this little stand where there is zero warp. The only other warp would be right here, and it's not even that noticeable, because who actually looks at the knob at the top of the scope right there? So, just to show you, you know what I'm talking about, is I'll set it to best full, and I'll put a color correction on, and you're going to see towards the bottom here, it's going to be much darker, and you're going to see all the brighter colors up front, and you're not even going to see blending. So here's a little blending right there. You know, and obviously when you're editing, you're going to notice the blending, but that doesn't mean the viewers are going to notice it. So let's add this color correction. I've been doing this kind of mixed a lot lately, so it's going to take a little while to update. Oh, there it is. So that really obvious blending that you just saw, it pretty much just went all the way right there, and then there's the second color correction right there, and there is no blending. And so I can drop this back down on the quality and RAM render it one more time. And that's my trick to doing, you know, getting zero warp into Twixtor. Is you want to only Twixtor when they don't move, during round ending kill cams, have kind of a darker color correction, you know, and if you do, you know, if there is something that you want Twixtor and it's just not working, then, you know, the color correction is not hiding it, then I suggest don't do it, you know. There are going to be times where there are clips that would look good Twixtor, but also shouldn't be, if that makes any sense. This is my trick. This is how I do it. This is how I get that zero warp perfection kind of Twixtor. And in my opinion, these are the best settings on YouTube, and it just might be better than After Effects, I don't know, but this is really good for Sony Vegas. And just a recap, you know, anything lower than 59.94, don't attempt to do it, it will not look good. Dark CC, kinda, it doesn't have to be a dark CC, that's just a recommendation to try and hide the blending, the warping, because you can see the scope is already kinda going to the vignette of the color correction. Have round ending kill cams, and that's about it. You don't have to keyframe, that was just a little tip towards a smoother transition, as you can see, instead of it being real time and then just stop, you know, on a dime to 4%. But that's really it, guys. That's my kind of little Twixtor tutorial and Twixtor settings. And like I said, I'll show you my render settings. So if we went to render, just in case if you guys want to get those down too. Alright. So check that. I'm going to customize template. These are my render settings right here. So I'm just going to go through the tabs kind of fast. You guys can go ahead and pause the video. Alright, so thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys learned something out of this. Anyways, thank you again for watching. And if you could, please like the video, because I gave away one of my best editing secrets ever, really. Everyone, I get asked daily for these settings, so if you guys could at least repay the favor and thumbs up the video, that'd be great. Anyways, guys, thank you. Peace.